sema jambo.
Jambo, jambo,
Siri Hashling Allen Cairns, the hook Oskun Queg Emiror Idrhunte O Eiring, Idr Idrugus Vana, Kurt Eringenia. Hross Schachtene, for a daughter of Tishkin der Rinke, Hjol, Agus Holtur Hele. Tug Kurt Hunskudiliak Sula, a will Bundex Self Help Africa, Agus Brighter Communities Loha. Agus oskil sultas na hernig, bheith an obair úntacha tar bun, chun saol bhaintear na Céinia a ausú. Chuir feachta spáilithe airig na n-imiróirí ar a gumas tús a chur le príomhaim an trís, milliún crán a chur, agus dá bhar áirecht bhuan a agant in na níag san Afric. Mae dîr tres tŵlin sy'n ar obi dîm belawdych lygain. Ys bywg y chap mae'r gymach slwyd yn torta, hoesdi o sgol a tŵl, agos rinc y bygiaw le sesiwn treinole. Fi yna hernig, agos loch ten yw rinc yn y chele, fi Tomas O'Shea, y rinc yn ddweud bosg y ciol gynnu wein, choma, agos ta mi ffyr fwechdif, gwr y mil y mil y mahagrif, as yn fawr tŵ wntach y chwrf y roing, agos na himrori y fegar ffac na himra y maerach. Tell me why we're here and where the idea came from.
I suppose I've been in Africa for 17 years now, my own charity first and then with self-help. And I've always had a dream or a vision of bringing an inter-county game or an all-star game to Africa. The dream is coming to fruition today. You know, we've a huge amount of people to thank for that. Self-Help Africa, our partners, the GPA, Brighter Communities Worldwide on the ground here. The players themselves, representatives of all the four codes. You have hurlers, footballers, ladies footballers, camogie players, yeah. From all over Ireland and all the counties. Such a historic day today.
And it's the really buy-in from the players through massive. Fundraising and commitment to the cause has been fantastic.
And the whole mission of the trip then is they all have raised 10,000 euros and we're going to plant 1 million trees this week. And what a collective legacy these players are going to leave.
I want you to visualise. You're wearing the green and red and mail.
Right?
All right,
Flash. We beat the final.
I'm telling you now, if there's one thing
we're come on, guys.
Don't lose my unbeaten record in Kenya. Okay, roll on, roll off, all right?
I guess it's lost that rule, shock. And here do rive grev clay idrhunte shul San Afric. And here do rive will Felix Mana again to the park here again level so. Agus and here do rive can out again the Timorisha tacht go Kenya. Agus at tag go in our humor. Agus stolen will to make our log and trying on so.
Not sure if getting off the flight yesterday or the altitude, but yeah, definitely. Trying to catch our breath there, it was tough early doors, but no, it's been really enjoyable. The whole day has been brilliant. And obviously getting to play with all the people that came out as well, men and women, it's brilliant, it's great fun.
I'm out of breath here, sort of talk here, it's really, really hard, not used to it.
And everybody getting on well in the third mixing.
Everyone's very charismatic, they're all getting on, chatting really well together, so great group of people, real genuine people.
Never seen anything like it. And everybody's just been so friendly and happy, you know, with everything they have. It's, makes you very grateful. It's humbling.
Mohan, we're talking about Cada has samach cosléir an slua ach gansi hirí. So tam chun cúpla fóchtla bheag omna shimansa. Cun a tántu?
Ma glóir sa hínbrin.
Tan dá sort an dá rev ma smaile te cosúla na chéile éirning agus meintu chénia?
Ia, ta siit anna cosúla na chéile is liig an tá cultúra an a láder an sa Nairobi tá cultúra gwina an a láder an éirin. Agus is slí at tá tán gáchion Naska hele kile, smaska hele kile. Mar Tommy an a broduul as an cultur san ag bin founder e a hespont is stoke. Ag spemi the nauni shin fe call an sa hinu.
Mar kinti well tasun gumintu tana vasun glehe. Is dasin gansi here ye yeskint tana diel gachenat.
There's something really special about playing out here in Kenya. With all this crowd watching, all the young boys and girls wanting to get involved as well. It's incredible, you know, and I think there's a real sense of unity and like, you know, we're all in this together kind of thing.
There's quite an array of talent there, and then there's a few inexperienced lads trying it for the first time as well.
Chancers
maybe if you want, but a great crack, and everyone seems to be enjoying it as well. I chanced the football earlier, so I suppose they're right to chance the hurling too. I don't think any of them, there's a few that haven't even played in Ireland, but they're getting their first game over in Africa.
When Michael Mahéran or Tanya was to spawn this Taishach or group of Arthur Rinkiori, agus bhór an nóirí an cora Olympach de Bhrúdaíse a bheith láthair ag an gléthe.
I'm here today with my coach also, who comes from Ireland, and I can say, Rada Paul. Rada Paul is a great man. He came to Kenya in 1976, and we have benefited a lot from him. His work that he has done to sports in this country is exemplary very well. So thank you very much, the team.
And this group is only going to be here for a week, but as you said, the legacy will continue for generations to come.
These players will get a sense of the impact they're going to make, but they will never understand the impacts decades from now. When families will be living off these trees and millions of more trees will be planted on the back of what they've done. Yeah. We hope that they'll ignite, you know, a spark in everybody at home and a spark in the GA community.
I think we're all very lucky, all the players that are here, to be in a position where we can raise funds and we're able to get buy-in from companies around Ireland. And I think what we're doing is really, really important because the people who are here, living here, are being really cruelly affected by climate change that really the Western world is creating.
Agasita Tashtil Trihir All in the Kenya, Hugn Group Air Nach Kurt, Erhunskadil Self Help Africa. Bequinia Gakiana Vada Gahaina, Erangurt, Erneferimori Artula, a caring guest. Jambo, jambo.
Jambo.
Mary, nice to meet you. Brian.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us on your farm.
I am doing dairy farming and a bit of maize planting, potato planting. We have always practiced soil testing. The company there help us to do that so that we know what kind of soil we have. To make that soil better, we have to put a bit of fertilizer to change that kind of acidity for our crops to grow well.
So how many cows have you on the farm?
I have almost six of them. Yeah, six of them. I take my milk to the quarter place. That we call it quarter. That is the premises we work. So I milk my animals in the morning and I take them there.
Yes.
Mostly we sell them. We produce for sale. So that we get the money to help us to do more work on the farm.
A voyagus le cower self-help Africa, tashli vaha haste of indigas the ferimori as a mania. Agzi da yearlish an uchtra na tool.
It has really sustained the Keringet community in terms of nutrition value. Because milk is what value very nutritious.
Thank you.
Next
food,
next
food.
Tabringo agus gedain fein quidvad in Afrik, skrista get trimmach agus ge kreme ihre. Ihr hit en vrein barstein so le tribli an nos. Dinen politorian daun gulor kainte fe aharo e raja. Ach ni vidau nach gae vur geminik. Ta self-help African so a gobre er a dalav gagar tirmach.
It's probably one of the countries in the world that produce the least carbon and it's probably having the most effect. There was an 8-month drought and you're coming over here to fields that are like destroyed.
There's a lot of landscape here where you can see the effects of drought and the effects of climate change. Something that we wouldn't see in Ireland, but you can absolutely see the effects of it here in Africa. You can see it in their faces, the importance of trees. You know, and one person said, without water there's no trees and without trees there's no water. And you can really see that it's a part, real part of their livelihood.
Brahm's complaining of having rain, and they've had, I think, over three seasons without it. The way they're surviving through it all is incredible, and yeah, just, I suppose, again, a real eye-opener.
Tá tionnachar an athraithe éráide agus an bochtana sa leanana le fiscint ar fud na Afrika. Thug an grúpa cuairt ar thionscadal ina bhfuil certain gan de tach á gur a dithe ag Brighter Communities agus iad a díreag astíochtaí carbónialaí a dú agus sláinte na dealach a ausú. So Jacqueline, we're here in the village of Kimmagul.
Kimmagul.
So tell me about the people that live here.
Here we are men and women, like 1,500. So we choose this house, this one, you can yes. see. Because the mother of this house is the oldest of all, like you. She have gray hair like you. This is the old jiko, where there is a lot of smoke inside. You can see the wall, the black. So we assume that in our heart, there's a lot of smoke turning black inside us. So we are congratulating Brighter Communities worldwide for giving us a knowledge to have a new stove called Lorena stove. So we want to start mixing the sand, water, and the clay.
I guess it's also a energy to break even iron.
I guess that's game than thought Kena Madele High and Lutinimas find at the Ershul in Malawi. When a carbon hagnas gachain tigalidu or kuyhona gachain vrien, go trihona. I guess bednis tachdinason, on made the east lean shit, find a clownitson arrogadon realtis, tachdistach, I guess can doubt tasson and a heart of doib.
When you're going to the hospital in the end, you're going to go to the hospital. You're going to go to the hospital. You're going to go to the hospital. Brighter Communities, you're going to go to the hospital. I'm going to go to the hospital, Dr. Collins, Mara Harleinche. Doctor, your collaboration with Brighter Communities has been established for a number of years. In what way has that helped what you do here?
So it has greatly helped what we do here in terms of service provision. We've managed to improve our service to our patients. We also managed to reduce on the number of mortalities across all the cadres, that is the maternal, neonatal, and also in the medical ward and the surgical ward. So it's a big improvement. We also managed to get more skilled training through organized trainings that we do on and on. And also we've managed to do exchange programs, and the team, we managed to get to see what people in Ireland do, and the team, the medical team from Ireland have also come here and seen what how we do things locally, and it's been immense.
Over your tofain, Platan Parsons, I said no shilling. I guess I'm asking an hospital shall you move?
Thought yeah, no, who will machine? We are checked on show can hospital on the NHA call. Tanask Lodge, if I'd been a Fihablin, I can start show. Showing she or running she the oldest in Kayla, running she doctory, change she the Hollis and all, Okashanwari go Gil on the Annie and show. I was chinning on oldest because the doctor Shin said Dothro, Neo on where I go on the Annie, I change on toilet. I was running she the oldest Gahoria or he Mahaka, I was a quiz Lani Oga, Connor Sarah Maha Horse Dove, I was yeah, tá de sin tú an nasné agus an cadre a bheith is an dóspeil. Tá sé difriú le hospeide anéing nafuil, tá sé seachtíúil é cinse nó tá i gcéar an éan fao na hospeide athagan chun se seo 6 pictar nu éir ar an scéal dún. Tá sé bhhaid níosteach an seo ach tanna daoine hebh dócasach.
Bhí chótóca leis an obair cruig í an na daine go léir ann. Is an aspa áisina agus achfaní atácha, tá sé do creta. Stocha an dachreach sa tácha tuair dair dos na daine ann. Anas obair den scó í an siad bhís tóca leis.
I saw you interacting with the patients there a minute ago. What do you make of this place as it compared to what you do at home?
Yeah, well, I suppose compared to home, it's kind of scary. But we've been told that this is one of the better hospitals around. But, like, we complain a lot at home about
resources
and stuff that we don't have, and they have very little here, and there's still no complaints. And we just got to meet two newborns there, and the quietest little babies, and both of their mothers had no complaints. They were just happy to have a healthy baby, and even when we were in the labour ward, they have 3 beds, which is crazy. But they still just get on with it. We have definitely a lot more than they have, and it's, I suppose, we're in privileged positions.
How they manage the resources, I think, is like extremely impressive. You know, the staffing levels here, and they see something like 250,000 patients a year here with only 2 nurses inside in the kind of A&E department over there. So, like, I think, yes, our resources at home obviously can be better, but this kind of puts everything into a little bit more perspective, I suppose.
Tréistos na himiróirí an díomháilí fan in leis an nathrú éráide a dhiscin go saléir, bhí sé an óm gníomh, agus an óm difríocht fad téarmach a dhéanamh. Is OK? Cuastaí Swahili for enough?
Imatosha, Alan.
This is kick-starting the whole programme, which is amazing, and it's a historic day, a proud day for the players, and the legacy they're going to leave behind. You know, these trees, a million trees, is going to leave a huge impact on the environment. Many, many families and many, many communities and many schools will benefit from these trees in multiple ways, from food crops to cash crops to nitrogen into the soil, stabilising soil. 20 years ago, it was a full forest, so now we're hoping to, over the next few years, you know, bring it back to where it used to be. The trees we planted here today, we have avocado. That's an unbelievably crop in terms of what the nutrients it can give the people in terms of protein and minerals, but it's also a cash crop, and they can sell the excess. 1 million trees is significant for a group of 50 GA players from back home in Ireland. As I said, hundreds of thousands of families, they will never meet them. Long after they're gone, hundreds of thousands of families will be benefiting from these trees, including ancestors of these wonderful girls we've met today in the school.
Tommy Taka getting internal heart from the Crean of Hur. Kunsaha, one over Tranhona, Trish Dolavaimurza.
Atashim, a Vimram, Anabur Fad, Kuddis Nahat and a Gramaran. You know, Furisha Behead, Blianta Shirohin, Agus Tish and Arua Erode, Ha Tresh Tarlu, more people than down, you know, Ha Implach Mortgage in and the Hotness on Ha Scata Arrogate Balhe, Ebene, the Himorian, so Agus Rajasin Kuntarve, that's Nadine and so, they had in the Green, Shen Spikahog in the Milun Crown of Hur, Agus Bemina Mehe, Fakam Shachtene, so Nervamina Mehe. Big na cruinniú son, bheith sé dábhaltaí teachtaisteach a bheith a chomhaltaí agus péirad an airt bheith míd na fágann na son, bheith sé san na fágann airt léine chomh maith mar, you know, oscail súr míteach a seithe dúna.
I don't think we truly appreciated the impact that getting here, being here and taking action makes, and the importance of actually not just talking about climate change and sustainability, but actually getting down and making a difference. And today, you know, we spent hours on the hills planting trees, and it was something really special doing it with the locals. And you could just really feel the importance and the appreciation from the local people here in Kenya.
Planting trees is hard work, as you know, now. Does it make a difference, though, knowing that you've made a huge difference in Kenya this week?
Yeah, of course, yeah, it was very rewarding, and we got plenty of help from all the communities, planting everywhere we planted the trees, all the communities gave us plenty of help, and of course, we were all helping each other as well, but definitely, yeah, knowing that you're making a difference, it doesn't seem like work at all.
Tasigan sail, gudugan and kjolags and sport, kulturje fjula lichele, ags vise shinle feshkin kusileers de skaljana.
Tara Tosca grabbing the parsley skyle Igile Dangin and Vona got to two chat the shacher madden.
Yeah,
and they hit all to a quick rowing.
Oh yeah, just fall to the crit dog, especially to a former and so. Tosca Glory, Conogus, the Gimmertogus, the Gory and Tom Glerogus, throwing trust road just on a special to Tommy Doble to, you know, the Colleenogus and Bookley, Amaska Kailogus, you know, on crack, och. Along over Untuk Ayenov.
Just to see, I suppose, their background, their culture, the music and dance that they do, and then just to see the smiles on their face, like, and they're the happiest people that you can meet, and they're all so welcoming. They're such nice people, I thought it was really, really special.
The joy they brought us, and the joy we brought them, just meeting and the welcome they gave us without ever knowing. I didn't know very little about us, and we know very little about them. To see the connection straight away was very impacting on everyone, I think.
I mean, it's a school forge again, E10, school level clue, August Coil, if we're down near her. I guess I have them in Sota, Irvun Jorgs, Ir Freewood in the school, and brought her Colum O'Connell. Colum, tell me how you came to come from Mallow and Cork to E10.
Well, I moved to, I taught in Newbridge for a short while before I came. The school is what was founded and run by the Petition Brothers, and I'm a member. So an opportunity came up for me after a couple of years teaching in Ireland, and they were looking for two teachers in St. Patrick's. That time, many teachers were volunteers from overseas. So I grabbed the opportunity to put both hands. It was a great welcome for sports people who were willing to make a contribution. I learned more here about sports than I brought. In that sense, and I think that it was a great opportunity for me, and it opened up doors for me to become a coach and to also, of course, make my contribution in terms of the coaching of athletics particularly. But the school had a sporting tradition already, so I built on that. I built on the shoulders of others. Visitors are always welcome in this area. This is a rural area of Kenya. You cannot describe it as really a tourist area. So it's kind of off the beaten track in a sense. When people see visitors coming to E10, and especially coming to the school in St. Patrick's, they know how to appreciate them. They know the value of visitors. They're not an everyday affair, so to speak, in the lives of the people. So, and they're very welcoming. And I found that even throughout my life in E10. Maybe that's part of the reason why I stayed. But these iconic players from Ireland, that they're able to more or less come and see what impact they can have or what role they can have in lifting the spirits of people. They can be themselves even a bit more, and they can feel a certain freedom, and there's an acceptance there. They're able to integrate, they're able to get the crowd going, they were able to feel at home in a sense, and they weren't going to be judged how good they are at their sport or how important they are, you know. In a sense, it's a great level as well. Mm-hmm. You know, you're grounded a little bit when you go into a culture and maybe even to a situation that you're not very well known in. But then they see the real person. So they, maybe they saw another side of these sports people, which they can see for, they learn a bit about themselves as well as teaching to the Kenyans.
Chuig sé bhaim go mór ar siúr an mhróir nuair a tugadh aithantas ar ledóibh os cór na scoile.
Alan got to pick, you know, three people that he thought would deserve the jackets, and it was an honour receiving it, which, you know, I was kind of happy to get because, you know, having that African and Irish background in me, it made it really special getting the jacket.
Coming to here and getting the opportunity to work with children in Kenya was so special. Realising the opportunities they have, even though from the outside we look in and we think they have, you know, limited resources and limited opportunities, but I think the education system here, it provides every child with an opportunity to learn, you know, the basics of language and number, and the smile on their faces when we arrived, which was, you know, providing them with an opportunity to express themselves with the football, be welcomed by us. You know, to see the smile on their faces, their sense of achievement, learning some of our basic skills of Gaelic football and hurling, it was a very proud moment.
Le Ling na Cúirte ar scoil Neamh Pádraig, bhí deisigas na himiróirí an tím plíochta bhuinn le gym lúi chlasaithe na Céinia a eiscint.
We call this our gymnasium. So this is where we do our warm up and our warm down. Of course, also we do very specific exercises related to running, like running technique or flexibility or Pilates even for core strength. So we have a very simple approach, as you can see, for our gym. We don't have any sophisticated equipment, but you really don't need so much sophisticated equipment. So now he's putting them through their paces here. Just to give them an idea of a cross-section of the type of work we do in terms of exercise work, because exercise, like all sports nowadays, is an integral part of training for any sport, especially athletes being trained for a high level.
Let's talk numbers, world champions and Olympic champions.
Olympic champions, 7 gold medalists. I think I have about 15 medalists in all in Olympics, and then something like 35 world champions. But again, I was in an area which kind of was a great reservoir for talent. And of course, the school was a great focal point and gave me, as I said, a kind of a captive audience in terms of coaching.
Gan puin colata, vir na himidori airige bracken lae, agus tuirt fethe siún díon leis an lúi chlasa is fear ón Géinia.
Most of them start here, and some go 20k, depends with the sessions they have planned. But for you, I want you to see St. Patrick's, see E10 area, and back maybe to this place, so that we don't get lost or how.
Sheikh Lugger Maiden, I'm going to be in the low class of Kenya, 10 kilometers. I'm going to be in the middle of the truck. I'm going to be in the truck. How'd you find that?
Brilliant, yeah.
Tough to kill it hanging training.
Up there maybe, up there small bit. I will bring something into now when I get home.
No bad at all.
Not too bad. Tough.
Alan.
Good job.
How was that?
Go away, Brian, now.
Come on, you're not that bad.
I am.
How was that, like, Jack?
That was. It's a mental game, Orton, actually.
Is that right?
Durability, yeah. It was fine getting out to school, fine coming around, then we hit the hill.
Yeah.
That's where your head comes into it, so.
You're supposedly one of the fittest guys in Ireland, is this? How does that compare?
The altitude does make a difference, without a doubt. But you've got boys pacing you there.
Yeah, yeah.
It's just we're cruising, like, it's lovely. Even just looking at how the Kenyans move, they just glide.
Gliding along the ground, yeah.
They're just gliding.
But they have a totally different physique to us, haven't they?
They have. I suppose that's one of the big differences with GA. And with long distance running is we need power, strength.
Yeah.
For them it's just can I keep my weight low? Cruising across the ground over distance. So what an experience. I guess it's probably one of the things I was looking forward to most.
John Elimsa, Corridonda, I guess Aiden O'Shea and out Lech Vuyonsa. What do you think of the Irish guys and girls running?
Oh, it's really fun running with them. It's really a privilege to have the best athletes in the in Irish country. So we really say thank you for you guys joining us. It's fun, it's privilege, it's honor.
And they had no difficulty keeping up with you?
They were really motivated. They were really motivated, they enjoyed it, despite they were feeling hard running with us, but they really get motivated and run with us.
And were they looking for advice from you, how to run and how to...
Oh yeah, they were asking about how we run, how our sports, how our culture is, and they really, they will get all of our advice and ask them to about what they do there, about their sports, and they were really good about that.
How'd you find that, Aidan?
Yeah, it was enjoyable. So I'm half up at 5:30 in the morning for a run. But to be with athletes of this calibre, it's an amazing experience. And the run wasn't too bad. They kept it nice and steady early doors, but Myler and Begley took up the pace a bit down the stretch, so it was great fun.
Winter Lavarov.
Dagom Morrow.
Winter.
Liam Lamar.
I guess the Roche Countess in Luke Castle or Kenya.
Well, please be young, like Neil and Tom are fad, but like, be sheets in the raw, like, just, you know, be a great, so be kind.
I guess the Fratu and Gura and all are the Roche, and he's Dakra Rihin, so I can hear the shot.
Oh, Visha, yeah, just Visha Dakra's so kind of air, like, near out here, fall.
Yeah, but they hope to start. But the winner's 10 of us.
We're on 10 of us.
We're home to. Come on, guys.
James May, Irish.
A bad day.
I hope you enjoyed all that.
There's a few stragglers, but we're okay. And it's great and it's fantastic to experience and see you going out and running with the Kenyans. And now you have an idea what it is to run at altitude. And but it's nothing too demanding, you know. It's a bit. I say it's the attitude more than the altitude.
It's a once in a lifetime. When are you ever going to be running with a 10,000 k record holder? When are you ever going to be running with world champions, Commonwealth champions, here in Etain, where the home of champions? So this is a once in a lifetime. You'll never do it again, probably. So I think we should really cherish it and really be thankful and grateful for Brother Cullum and Ian for organising such a wonderful experience. Thanks a million. To the athletes yourselves, thanks for coming up and having us. We're humbled to be here with you and seeing what you do on a daily basis. I know there's only a session of one of three today, so we only joined you for the warm-up, but thank you so much, and we're really looking forward to the rest of the day. And fair play, I think, Myler, you came home with the victory there, did you? So I think I set the pace. I'm taking the award for being the pace setter, but other than that, it was a great day. So thanks, everybody. Thank you.
How important is it for you as ambassador to have the Irish community and the Kenyan community coming together?
It's just wonderful to have Ireland's top athletes here in Kenya, and they're here for a very good cause. Kenya, although it's one of the countries that has caused the least emissions, is one of the countries most affected by climate change. So the work to raise awareness around the importance of planting trees and to actually plant the trees and prevent soil erosion is just so important. And then, of course, it's wonderful for us as the embassy because they are supporting our mission to build stronger people-to-people and even government-to-government ties between Ireland and Kenya. And I think it's very important. They're planting indigenous trees and they're planting trees that will support local communities for many years to come. But I also think the memories of it, the relationships we build, I mean, we all know sport is so important for building communities, for building contacts, for building friendships.
Coming over here, we didn't really know what to expect. We know we were coming over on a mission to plant a million trees, but what we've seen and what we've got out of the trip can hardly be put into words.
Kugelon Rod Weimar and Cunanir Nara, Major in Africa, Gahara, Smithskulna, Naposhti, Major Gaira Gakla, Eg Dousa, Eg Kana, Tashi Joska Huntuk Erfad.
It really makes you appreciate what you have at home, and it's definitely something that I'll be going home with a newfound appreciation for the simple things in life.
Hopefully we can bring home some of what they gave us, some of the warmth and some of the joy. I look forward to even getting back here at some stage again and trying to do some more.
It's a massive humbling experience. Seeing the work that Self Help Africa and the broader communities do around Kenya has been absolutely incredible. Very grateful to be play a small part in that. Some of the money we raised hopefully will go to great use. I'm definitely going home with a different perspective on life.
Kenya, asante sare. Kenya, how you boy. Kenya, asante sare. You're a mila from this grateful Irish crew.
Jumbo!